Good afternoon, Red Bank. It's not very often you get two pep rallies in 1 week, but that's exactly what we've got after the academic pep rally on Wednesday. We're going to strike up the band one more time in less than an hour.
And the fun will continue tomorrow night. The 2017 talent show is happening on Saturday night in the new gym. We'll have a special preview coming up next.
The Lions football team is home tonight in the den for the third round of the playoffs, and the basketball teams open up their season this week. You'll see the outlook for the Hoopsters. It's all coming up in sports.
And we've got some great features for you today. They include an ice cream tasting contest, an episode of Finish the Lyrics, and a brand new rap music video. You'll see all coming up a little later in the show.
It's Friday, November 17th, and you're watching the main news.
Red Bank has talent, and that's a fact that will be verified on Saturday night. The 2017 talent show happens tomorrow night at 7 in the new gym, and everyone is invited. 10 different acts will be competing for the top prize of $100 cash. We talked to the show's coordinator to get all the details.
I'm here with Ms. Smith, and can you tell us a little bit about the talent show?
Talent show is going to be Saturday, November 18th at 7 o'clock. Admission is $5.
Do you know if the acts are going to be good this year?
Yeah, we had a whole lot of people try out, so we were able to pick the top 10, and they are the finalists, and they're going to duke it out for second, third place. First prize is $100 cash.
Do you have any advice for people that are trying out, and hopefully if they make it?
Don't be nervous. Just get up there. I mean, it's hard to not be nervous, but don't be nervous. I mean,
can you give us a little preview of you singing?
Listen, seeing you got ritualistic plans in my store for addiction for now, cause I'm falling apart.
Admissions to the show is $5, but it's guaranteed to be entertaining. 7 tomorrow night. Come on out.
Science is not all book work, and Ms. Manning's physics class just proved that point. Members of the class had to design and construct a catapult that would launch an egg in the air for 50 feet. We were there on the day they tested their contraptions. Jeremiah Welch has the story.
Hey, I'm here with Will Thomas. Will Thomas, what do you think about the catapult, man?
Project. Awesome, man. Lots of fun.
It is. So how'd y'all prepare to like build this thing? Did y'all get any instructions, or was it just go out and do it?
Hey, no, she said that it had to be within like a 3-foot by 3-foot square, and that's all I knew about it. And I didn't even remember it till like 2 nights ago.
You recommend people taking physics?
Yes, definitely take physics.
What happens is that they are supposed to do calculations and find out how far their egg is going to travel, which is 50 feet. and they're supposed to figure out what angle it is released, because it is a projectile going in two different motions. It's going vertically and it's going horizontally. And so they're supposed to figure out the angle at which to release it to go the length of 50 feet. And they're supposed to then build it so those dimensions will be there. We didn't have a lot of success today. That's what they do. It's called kinematics. Study of kinematics in two dimensions is what it is.
So do you think your class enjoyed this though?
Oh, I enjoyed it. I love it. I think the kids love it too.
The VICA Club just wrapped up a unique form of community service. This past Sunday, members went to a party for kids at WTCI-TV, the public television station. You're going really fast. The public television station, their job was to entertain the kids while dressed in costumes of popular cartoon characters. And as you're about to see, a good time was had by all.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine, just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel a good, good creeping up on you, so just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance.
It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't be control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the.
Well, we are less than a week away from Thanksgiving, everyone's favorite eating holiday of the year, Thanksgiving. Day is coming on Thursday. Our Kareth Kearns wanted to put everyone in a good mood for the holiday, so she has put together some Thanksgiving humor.
Who doesn't eat on Thanksgiving?
Who doesn't eat on Thanksgiving? I don't know.
A turkey, because it's always stuffed. I'm with Zion. What's your plans for Thanksgiving?
To eat, and get fat, and get lit.
What's your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Let me think. I don't even dress is my favorite Thanksgiving food.
All right, thank you. Hi, I'm with Ms. Kearns. What are your plans for Thanksgiving?
To eat.
What's your favorite food?
It's easier to say what I don't like, but my most favorite is smoked turkey.
Why was the Thanksgiving soup so expensive?
Why?
Had 24 carrots.
That's a dad
joke. Well, the football team has advanced to the third round of the playoffs.
And we'll show you how they did it. Let's get the highlights as we head on over to sports.
Get away, got that boss view. Hold on to Clancy, man. Hey, tropical land on there. That old shoe, bow shoe, red as well. Got that new mine, blue mine, ready to pair up. Like, oh, tropical berry in there.
The Lions football team faced another big physical team in the second round of the playoffs, but that didn't worry our Lions. They know that the bigger they are, the harder they fall. We've got your highlights from Red Bank and York Institute. Roll that tape. The Lions attack early in this one. Quarterback Maddox Wilkie drops back and finds number 10, David Cosme, over the middle. This fingertip grab is a good for 30 yards. Running back number 2, Zay Brown, will take it from there. He takes it right up the middle for a touchdown, and Red Bank led 7-0. Then came a scary moment. Lions defender Xavier Doss would dislocate his hip, and the entire team surrounded their teammate to give him support. But then Red Bank got right back to business. Quarterback Maddox Wilkie is going deep to wide open Calvin Jackson. The long bomb results in another Lions touchdown. That gave the cheerleaders something to cheer about. It's the second quarter now, and Maddox Wilkie is looking long again. It's another bomb, this time to David Cosby, and no one is going to catch him. Touchdown, Red Bank. And the Lions led 21-7. But Red Bank wasn't done. Out of the shotgun, Maddox Wilkie finds number 6, Dede Porter, on the slant pattern, and then he makes some moves after the catch. This play is good for 23 yards. Then number 2, Zay Brown, powering his way up the middle for a 5-yard touchdown run. But it wasn't just the offense that shined. On defense, watch pass rusher number 11, Ivan Young, get double-teamed on the block. But Ivan keeps fighting through it and will make the sneak. Oh, sack. That got the crowd pumped up. Meanwhile, back on offense, number 5, Calvin Jackson, gets the direct snap and follows his offensive line into the end zone for 6 more points. York tries to get back in the game with a trick play. The running back will stop and throw the long ball, but watch number 10, David Cosby, leap into the air to make the interception. What a play. Watch it in slow motion. David actually brings in the catch with just one arm. What a pick. From here, Red Bank puts the nail in the coffin. It's number 5, Calvin Jackson, on the sweep, and he finds a hole, and he's gone for the long touchdown run. Red Bank goes on to cruise 42-7.
Number 5, Calvin Jackson, on the carry for a touchdown.
The Lions have another home game tonight in the third round of the playoffs. Red Bank will be hosting Smith County, and to get the team pumped up, we've got a pep rally in less than an hour. There will also be face painting and other activities in the parking lot before the game. Kickoff is set for 7 o'clock. Come on out. Let's go, Big Blue. Football has taken most of the spotlight, but we don't want to overlook the basketball teams. Both boys and girls teams open the season on Tuesday with impressive wins over the Chattanooga Patriots. Both teams have their sights set on winning district title. Our Jalen Cargill has the outlook on the upcoming season.
I'm here with Coach Fike. Tell me, how do you feel about the upcoming basketball season?
I think we're going to be pretty good. We were pretty young last year and inexperienced this year. We get everybody back. We've got a lot of depth. Practices have been fun this year. I'm looking forward to it, and hopefully we can get in the top 4 and be able to compete for a district and region championship.
How do you feel about the upcoming basketball season?
I feel like it's going to be great. I feel like we're going to make it all the way and beat everybody else in our region, in our district.
All right, thank you.
I am here with Ms. McGinnis. How do you feel about the upcoming basketball season?
I feel really good about it. We've got all our girls back this year, and we're adding some new girls to the team. We've got a lot of high expectations and trying to defend our title from last year. So I feel really good about the work we've been putting in and the effort that these girls have shown me.
Thank you. I'm here with Layla Babb. Layla, how do you feel about the upcoming basketball season going into your senior year?
I feel like it's going to go very well because we made it to the second round of regions last year, and we basically have like the same team, but we've also got like new players, and we have a lot of potential, so I feel like we're going to go as far or farther than we did last year.
Okay, thank you. I'm here with Maya Kennebrew. Maya, how do you feel about the upcoming basketball season going into your senior year?
I'm very excited. We have a lot of potential this year. We have a lot of new freshmen, a lot of sophomores, and I think we can go farther than what we think we could.
Okay. The first game will be hosted here at RBHS. Make sure to come out and support the Lions.
The Hoopsters play again tonight on the road. Red Bank travels to Boyd Buchanan. The girls play at 6 o'clock with the guys following at 7:30. But the next home game will be a biggie. On Monday, Saudi Daisy is coming to our Lions Den. Make your plans to be there on Monday night as we crush the Trojans. That's all for sports. Back to you.
Ice cream, you scream. We all scream for ice cream. But can you identify the flavors of your favorite ice cream? Our crew hit the hallways armed with several different flavors of Haagen-Dazs and Ben & Jerry's ice cream. So let's find out, do you know your flavors of ice cream?
Boy, do you like ice cream? No. We don't care. We went roaming around the halls and had people taste test our ice cream.
I'm with Ivan, Michael, and Calvin, and we're playing the blind test, ice cream test. So what do you think it is?
S'mores.
That's monkey bread.
It's Rocky Road.
No!
It's on there. It's on there. Yeah, I think it's... Well, what you
tasting? I have some chocolate fudge in there.
I'm going with Rocky Road.
All right, y'all open your eyes. Y'all see the flavor. It's got marshmallow, swirls,
caramel.
And fudge.
Caramel.
Oh. Yeah, you want to taste some ice cream here?
Guess what flavor it is.
Yeah, guess what flavor it is. Come on. You get the ice cream.
Is it chocolate?
I know.
Boy, what are you tasting?
Okay.
Guess what flavor it is.
Is that Rocky Road?
Yeah.
It's a caramel chocolate.
Crap,
butter.
Okay.
Is it good?
It's good, you're good.
Boy, what are you tasting? Sponsored by Little Caesars.
Oh, that's Chunky Monkey. That's Chunky Monkey.
Nope.
That's banana.
Oh,
nope.
Strawberry sundae, shortcake.
Nope.
Almost got it.
What's the name of it?
It's an oatmeal.
I knew that.
So it's like,
no, he didn't.
Let me try again.
Oh, it's oatmeal. Oatmeal.
It's oatmeal.
No, yeah, not oatmeal.
What? Well, I'm out, man.
All right, you're good.
That's okay, fine. Where's my... I know it's something with chocolate.
And...
I don't know, is it like peanut butter or something?
Eat it.
It's really ice cream.
It's dope, dude, trust me.
Oh yeah.
That's pretty good.
Boy, what you tasting?
Oatmeal cookie.
Hey yo, Brian.
I got it.
You wanna taste some ice cream?
No.
Yes.
What am I doing?
Guess what flavor that is. You don't like it? She didn't like it. It's delicious.
Wait,
okay.
How are we going to know what to put
I'll give
the
it
spoon?
To you. Yeah.
Oh, I'm so confused. Did I get any?
Yeah.
Wait, where's the
spoon? Oh.
It's chocolate.
Wow.
Did I spill some on my shirt?
Yes. Oh. Hold your thought. Hold your thought. So what do you think it is?
It is chocolate, but it does have something else in it.
And?
Like, mm-hmm. I don't know, like caramel or something?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, open your eyes. It's fish food, so chocolate, caramel, marshmallow.
Hey!
Their ice cream. But do you know your music? Sarah Boganovic grabbed her music player and went to find out. Here now is the third installment of Finish the Lyrics.
You get the both worlds. Take a step, then you rock out the show.
Oh my god, I don't want to do it.
We're soaring, we're flying. There's not a star in heaven that we can't reach. If you're trying, yeah, we're breaking free. Oh, we're breaking free.
Meanie, money, mo. Catch up, bad chick by her toe. If she holler, if she holler, let her go.
Eenie, meanie, miney, mo. Tom's been around that track, so it's not just gonna happen like that.
No. I'm ready.
That's a baby.
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it.
I don't know the words.
Alright, stop. Collaborate and listen.
Ice is back with a brand new invention.
No. I don't do this, but go ahead on, break them off with a little previews of the remix. Now I'm not trying to be rude, but hey pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do reminds me of my Lexus cool. That's why I'm all up in your grill, trying to get you to a hotel. You must be a football coach, the way you got me playing the field. So
oh, it's that train noise.
That's all I got.
What is it? It's like,
oh, baby, give me that toot toot. Beep beep.
One of the most popular videos making the rounds on YouTube is a parody about Justin Bieber taking over a website. But don't worry, if you haven't seen it, our scholar Pilcher has a parody of a parody. Enjoy.
Hey, what's up, internet? Guess who? It's Justin Bieber, and I've taken over Funny or Die. It's mine, I bought it. And now it's Bieber or Die. Anything that's not Bieber dies. I'm childish, I do what children do. I ride on ponies, I scribble on walls, and I pay people to feed me. Sometimes I don't feel like walking, so I make people carry me around. Let's go get a lollipop. I don't sleep at nap time, and I swim directly after I eat. I don't care. I once walked into a club. They said, "Sir, you're not old enough." So I bought the club, and I made it a Chuck E. Cheese. Now who's old enough? So remember this. This is Bieber's world, and you're just living in it. Bieber or die.
It's Friday, and we've got an awesome music video to get you in the mood for the weekend. It's an original rap featuring some of the best rappers at our school, and it also features some wannabe rappers. But good or bad, you're guaranteed to be entertained. Our Ben Nyman put it all together. Roll it.
I'm here with Ron. I'm here with Bronson. I'm here with Spencer. I'm here with Demario. If you're a rapper, what would your ad lib be?
You know, I like keeping things real, so I'm gonna do it.
This one's for Brooklyn.
Yeah, baby.
Zoink.
But why you stopping?
Keep going, I just made it mine. Yeah, you know I'm passing on my classes. 3.8 GPA, I might just go the other day. Pass the bag away, I'm back today. You know I got to get the drag today like it's a drag race.
Yeah,
he lying, he don't got a 3.8. He got a 2.5. He got the 10, hit him in his end. And I'm making him, yeah, right there. I don't know what he doing. Acting like some fools, and I keep the tool.
Pop, 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 boom!
Dollar, dollar, please, why you gotta be a savage? Now I got an addiction, addicted to the cabbage. Started my life hopeless and turned it to some lavish. Sorry, little mama, no drama, don't want no baggage. Started getting money, can't spend it, I gotta stack it. Mama told me never let her catch you lacking, and I caught them lacking. Now they wiping up with napkins, that's automatic. Keep me safe and things started ecstatic. When I started rapping, wasn't whipping, wasn't happy.
Super, super fat. Nobody likes these rhymes because nobody has a good time.
I'm straight out of Red Bank, but it's so much 12, they call it Fed Bank.
See? Every day, baby.
I bet. Okay. 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 Bet. Okay.
Well, once again, the weather for tonight's football game is looking good.
But tomorrow there's going to be some rain. Let's get the latest forecast as we head on over to weather.
Fall. Summer. Spring. Winter. When I was a young one, my media teacher told me the story of how he and his students who heroically ended the Great Pollination Attack. Mr. Wagner and his students transformed the pollination into a newscast where viewers and non-viewers from all over the world could watch and listen together in peace and harmony. They named this forecast the Main News. The newscast accomplished many remarkable things last year, but sadly their time on that cast came to an end. And like the cycle of the seasons, the cycle of the Main News began new.
We've been lucky all year with our weather for Friday night football, and it looks like that luck will continue tonight. Let's look at the numbers. Today's high temperature will be a pleasant 64 degrees, this after a low last night of 49. It'll be perfect weather for Friday night football, but as we look at the five-day forecast, you'll see we have some rain on the way for tomorrow. The clouds will thicken up in the morning, but the rain should hold off until about 3 in the afternoon.
Precipitation will continue until the early evening. We will then see a significant drop in the temperature for Sunday, with the high only expected to reach 51 degrees. But we should be dry for most of Thanksgiving week. Everyone have a great holiday. Back to the news desk.
Well, it's birthday time on the main news.
Let's see who will be celebrating a B-Day next week.
So that'll wrap up our show. Come on out, to the football game as the guys continue their quest to state. And don't forget the basketball teams will battle Saudi on Monday in the Den.
Next week is a short week, so there won't be a main news. But we'll be back with a brand new episode after Thanksgiving break. Thanks for watching. Peace out, Red Bank. And then we start to dance, and I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me.